Babymetal and Electric Call Boy, or Electric Call Boy and Babymetal, as we should perhaps be referring to it. Either way, the main thing is these two artists are finally on a song together. They have been circling around each other for a while. We know they're both going to be at Foxfest this weekend, which is exciting stuff. And look, I'm just really interested to see what these two groups do together. Now, I was I first actually heard of Electric Call Boy when I was in the Fox God Bar, which is in Tokyo, here in Tokyo. And I was there with a lot of Babymetal fans, and Babymetal got the shirt. They were playing some music over the TV of like bands who were basically like friends of Babymetal. And this one came up, never heard of them before. And just immediately struck me that it's like, okay, this is just very fun music, Electric Call Boy. It's like, it's catchy, it's a little bit sort of twee and cheesy, but in a fun, very deliberate way. Big choruses, big beats. But we think of Babymetal, obviously a fun band, but obviously also very known for much more technical songs, you know, really exploring every single variety of metal. I mean, you look at the various things they've done, even in the first three albums, you know, the mixture of J-pop and metal, then like metal resistance went through so many different things, went prog and everything. Then of course we had the more higher production stuff on Metal Galaxy. They have really done everything. So the interesting thing is, how is this collaboration going to work? We're going to find out because it has just come out. We're going to listen to it now. I must set my expectations first of all. Because this is Electric Call Boy's song, I'm expecting it to be an Electric Call Boy style song. So basically, big beats, catchy, everybody sing along and dance kind of thing, with just some like Babymetal like vocals thrown in. For me, the collaboration that Babymetal did with F-Hero and Body Slam, that three-way collaboration was just like, that for me was like the gold standard for collaborations. But it's because all three contributing artists were so different, they had lots of room. Look, I'm waiting to hear it. I thought I'd do this intro first, but let's just get in. Let's just hear this song. I'm excited to see where this goes. I'm just expecting, all I'm looking for, I'll be surprised by anything more. I'm just looking forward to a big, catchy song, Babymetal, and that good, fun energy that you get from Electric Call Boy, at least as far as I know. Let's do this. All right, let's go. Okay. The intro seems to suggest.
Every night when the sky turns red up above, I feel the beat in my veins and I'm searching for love. You know that hips don't lie, and if you're hypnotized, just give me one more try.
Is that a Shakira reference? That's very loud. Okay, I can feel the metal side coming through now. This is not the way I expected. Okay, so Babymetal's contribution. Again, like Babymetal's contribution. Just like in Leave It All Behind. Bouncing around, going through different sort of styles of delivery. I really like that. That's catchy. That is catchy. Okay, we got a catchy song. Let's see what they do in the bridge. It's very club. Okay, you're gonna come dropping back in. Okay, they're definitely... They're having fun with the metal, which I like. Nice breakdown. Hi! There's just enough clever ideas in here to keep it from sounding complacent. And it's very catchy. I get the feeling that a lot of people are going to be playing this on repeat play for a very long time. Alright, okay. Yeah, this... Now, in many ways, this was exactly what I had expected, but I guess it's one of those things. If you know that you're going to get something which is rather of a fairly simple formula, you want them to do all of the tricks, you know, not to sound complacent. And yeah, so we knew we were going to get like steady club beat. We knew we were going to get catchy sort of chanting choruses. Nothing in here was like... So there was nothing in here that was completely out of left field. But what I really liked is that within the format that they set out, this sort of simple, catchy, addictive format, they did lots of different things. You know, like there was lots of little different vocal bits they jumped between. We had a lot of call and answer style vocals. It seemed like it was a bit hard to tell because it was very loud, compressed mix, which, again, that's exactly what you'd expect for this type of music before anyone complains. But it was kind of hard to tell exactly how the vocals were being shared up between the various ladies of BABYMETAL. But I certainly got the feeling like everyone was getting a little bit of a workout here. It was nice, the interplay between all the vocalists there. It sounded fun. It had that sort of club feel of having like lots of vocalists together sort of bouncing off each other. But musically, it was really cool. You know, it started off with a little bit of a sort of a, I don't want to say cheesy, but because like I say, a lot of the cheesiness that I associate with Electric Callboy is like very intentional cheesiness. It's kind of like, it's funny, sort of, it's fun cheese. And there's kind of this sort of very Eurobeat style club beat starts at the beginning. Very old school, very 90s. And then as the guitar stuff and everything kicks in, it's not like they just sort of do away with that. The club beat stays underneath and it stays very solid and central to the song, but you add those harder elements. The shouted vocals, they were kind of shouted, but in a chant along way. So it wasn't one of those things that I think would alienate someone if you're not big into metal music. I know I'm not a big fan of a lot of shouty, screamy vocals a lot of the time, but in this particular song, it was done in a way where it was just like sort of, you know, like shouting something at the audience, asking to shout it back. And even the call and answer nature of the vocals showed that that's kind of like the feeling it was going for. It was just very, you know, very much something that he felt was very sort of infectiously fun song. I'm sure we're going to be seeing this at like Foxfest, and apparently they're going to be playing some dates together in Europe this year as well, so I'm sure this song's going to get a good workout. And I mean, hey, this is one of those songs, it's like designed for live fun. So 100%. Now, obviously, the music video is coming out for this in the next 24 hours. I might come back and do a reaction to the music video as well. I imagine it's probably going to be quite fun based on a lot of the stuff that I've seen from Electric Callboy before. So I'm going to be interested to see how that goes. Musically, though, this was a barrel of laughs. This was really cool. Catchy as hell. I really liked that breakdown in the bridge. You know, sort of at first I was like, okay, typical club bridge, we go quiet and then we're building, everything's phasing up, but then they went to that halftime bit, which again, it's not like reinventing the wheel, but really cool how they went to that, because it lent into the metal side. Everything halftime, big, heavy, you know, really feeling all the beats. And then of course it gives you, it sort of at the same time, it like winds up the spring so that you can burst into that final chorus with a lot more energy. But even the last chorus, they started it with the the final chorus starts with a breakdown and then sort of drops in, which again is very very much a stereotype of Japanese style songwriting. So this had like lots of little flavors of various little simple techniques, but all put together with this catchy chorus, with this catchy fun vibe, the whole feel of it, very infectious. I really like this. Now, this is going to be one of those songs where, like I said, I think people are going to play this to death over the next sort of few months. You're going to hear this on repeat play. I think it's one of those songs where, because it is so much based around a very catchy hook that goes round and round and round, I get the feeling you're going to play it to death like the next month or so, and then you're probably going to need to like have a few months off. It's going to be one of those songs where you're going to have a few months off after you've heard it like about a billion times. So it's like, all right, I've overplayed that now. And then you'll leave it behind, and then maybe like sometime around summer of next year, you'll be like, Hey, do you know what? Ratatata was a really, really cool, like, summer song. You put it on and it will suddenly be reinvigorated. It'll be one of those songs where you'll play it solidly for an entire month, then forget about it for, like, half a year, and then play it again solidly for an entire month. Anyway, these are my thoughts. I thought this was really cool. A lot of fun. I'm glad that we get on this early. Of course, as I mentioned, the music video is coming out for this in the next 24 hours. This is apparently releasing midnight everywhere. So depending on your time zone, you should be getting it soon if you don't have it already. I thought this was really cool, really fun, really what I expected, but not in a sort of complacent, just throw it away kind of way, in a way that it seemed to maximize the potential of everything that I expected it to be. Did it in a really cool way. A lot of fun, nothing overcomplicated. Do I like it as much as Leave It All Behind? I didn't think it had as much to get into as Leave It All Behind, but it is more immediately infectious, more immediately just sort of like a crowd pleaser. So yeah, I think on that sort of, and basically on all the terms that I was expecting to engage with it, it was really awesome. So there you go. Those are my thoughts. Get in the comments, tell me what you think. And until I hopefully see you very soon in Japan for the next one of these. For now, ciao, ciao.